My wife's just showed me her boobs. I'm gonna put this in so it annoys her. Welcome back to the channel, guys. So here we are in my backyard again. Well, as you've seen from the title, let's discuss the big debate. Flat pedals, clip pedals. So I've been riding just over 7 years. And my background is motocross, BMX, all that sort of thing. So I started on flats. But then I got sort of drawn into everyone was running clips and I always sort of wondered why. And when I moved out here to Portugal 6 years ago, I instantly swapped to clips because I was going to be riding a lot. I was going to be able to learn riding clips. Now, 6 years on, I can unclip clip, no issues. But it wasn't until middle of last year I fancied to go on the flat pedals again. And my God, what a bit of a shock to the system that was. You don't realize how lazy you become riding clips for when you go back on flats. Like, you go off a jump and your feet go flying off, and there's so much technique that you sort of don't use anymore, which helps so much with the riding. Now, with the lockdown and everything happening, I was still able to ride around here with my son, and I made it upon myself. My wife's just showed me her boobs. I'm going to put this in so it annoys her. So with all the lockdown that's happened, I was still able to ride around my house with my son. I made it a bit of a mission to try and get used to the flat pedals again. So I put them on. So they've been on now a couple of months. And then I was once the lockdown sort of lifted a little bit, I was able to get on the local trails. And I've been really enjoying it. You know, it sort of opens up the track a bit more. You're able to sort of take a little bit of a risk on corners and that. And even though, no matter how confident you are on clips and all that sort of thing, you still got to unclip to clip back in. And the same with the flats, like, you can take your foot off and you've got to find that position again, but you have a bit more freedom with the flat pedal. And there's two main sort of shoes that I use. I use Crank Brothers when I'm clipping in, which I only use Crank Brothers because they're the first clip pedal I went to when I swapped over to clips. And I've tried other brands like the Shimano SPDs, HT, but I think with anyone can agree with this, once you start with a clip pedal, you almost get used to it. And these are the shoes. I run them quite far back, so they're like almost like a flat pedal stance. But then for the flat pedals, I run these pedals with, I think they call them Terrapins. Like, I think they protrude 10 mil. And the shoes I use, obviously, with the Sam Hill 510 impacts. They've got a massive sole, real soft. Anyone out there knows about flat pedals, you know that 510 are the shoe to go to. And there's only a few riders out there who still race and can do anything good with the flat pedals. You know, Sam Hill is obviously the king of flats. Then you've got Brendan Fairclough. He's always been on flats. You've got Conor Fearon. He's Aussie like Sam Hill. He still absolutely smashes it. And I think he might have been, he was certainly close to winning the World Cup in Leogang until Gwyn's famous chainless run. But I think it might have been Sam Hill in Mirabel. He was the last flat pedal winner, or Giaf earning Cairns, one of them. But like, G's a rider, I think he can swap between both pretty easy. And for me, I wanted to really put some effort into the flat pedal, see if I could get some different techniques, different riding. You know, I know for a fact I corner faster in flat pedals. I don't know whether it's my motocross background or what, but I can corner a lot better in the flat pedals. But on the fast, rougher stuff, I know for a fact I'm a bit more stable in the clip. So, like I said earlier, there's a battle between comfort and sort of that, you know, what you feel most comfortable on. And at the minute, I feel pretty comfortable on both. But I wanted to do a timed run where I did a few runs on the clips, a few runs on the flats, same day, same conditions, you know, and put a time run together. And I'm gonna put that up in a second. But I was actually quite shocked at the time difference of one pedal to the other, you know, clips or flats. And it's sort of messing my head a little bit now because I didn't expect to be faster in the one that was the fastest. So let's go to that timed run. This is track line. You know, we've seen it before, but it's a track I know well. It's fast, flowy off camber, roots loose. It's good for both types of shoes and pedals. So yeah, let's watch that and then we'll talk about after. So there you are. I was faster on the flat pedal by 4 seconds, which it has really messed with my head a little bit, because I thought the video on the left was me on the clips, and that's the fastest run I've ever done down that track. And then I put the flats on and then went 4 seconds faster, and I was literally like, it wasn't just because it was later in the day and all that sort of stuff, because like I said, I know these tracks like the back of my hand. And I don't know, at the top to the road, you can see it's like bang on equal, but further down you get a lot more like looser, slightly off cambered corners where I was able to hit the corners and all that sort of stuff better. And for sure, I felt a little bit more fatigued once I got to the end on the flat pedals. Now, I think that was the sixth run. I think I did 3 runs on each. So like later in the day, I would have been a bit more tired. So that would have been, you know, a factor as well. But like I said, I'm pretty shocked at being 4 seconds faster on a platform that I've barely used and not really used to. And clips I've raced for the past 6 years, you know, it's sort of been my go-to. I have a bit of fun on the flats, but when I fully committed to the flats, I was quite surprised at the outcome. I also put a thing out on Instagram, some, you know, what do people run? You know, what are people using? What do they prefer, why? And here's some of their answers. So I'm put, flats gives me more confidence when pulling tricks in bailing. So I guess he's a bit more of a dirt jumper. So yeah, this guy said, flat since an accident where I couldn't unclip, causing me to injure my foot and ankle, which yeah, if you haven't got good mobility in your feet, ankles, it's gonna be hard to unclip. Someone else, racing over rough ground, sprinting, got to be clips. But getting rowdy, got to be flats. Which yeah, there's nothing like quite like that. Clips, I seem to keep the bike under me a lot easier and get over obstacles with it. Love the comfort, so this one's a flat pedals. Love the comfort of dropping a foot when things get rowdy with flats. Can definitely appreciate clips, which yeah. So yeah, a lot of it is about, you know, confidence. So the rough stuff and, you know, jumping, you definitely got that bit more stability with the clips. And then, you know, other people say they just feel more confident putting a foot out. The younger generation, they just come in expecting that you have to run clip pedals. You know, I think it's a bit like how I think of motocross. Like no one runs 2 strokes anymore. Everyone's trying a 4 stroke, and the 4 stroke makes you a bit lazy, which is the same sort of thing with these clips and flat pedals. The clips, you certainly can charge and you know your feet are always there, but you lose a bit of technique, I honestly think. And when you watch the videos like Sam Brendan, you know, I think Joe Smith, he's a top English rider. You know, there's literally a very small amount of people that are still smashing it on flat pedals. And I think the younger generation just see, obviously, the Gwynns, Greg Minnaar, everyone, you know, running clips, and that's the way you've got to go. I'm personally going to run the flats a bit more, see how it goes. You know, obviously in some tracks, especially here in Portugal, there's some where I know that I'm going to be fast on the clips. And but it's going to be a good year. You know, I'm going to try it. Maybe at the World Cup here in Lausanne, I'm going to keep running flats till then, because the Lausanne track is very sort of, some sections are quite old school, off camber, flat, fast berms, where it might work better, you know, who knows. But certainly an eye opener, that's for sure. And a thing that really got me thinking, I think it was a week ago or two, Wyn Masters did an interview with Nigel Page, and he was like, he doesn't understand why more people don't run flats before even trying clips. And there's certain riders like, I think Sam Blenkinsop, he won a World Cup when he was on flats, but hasn't on clips. And now I know everyone's got faster and all that sort of stuff, but it certainly shows that some riders especially could go bloody well on flat pedals. But I don't know whether it's the way the tracks are changing at World Cups or that sort of thing. They've lost like the Champries and the Schladmings where, you know, it's off camber, slippy, rooty. I think Andorra, you know, that's still very much an old schoolish track. I've ridden there and know for a fact that, you know, you can pedal out the gate, big sprint, and then it's all just bike skill. So yeah, you know, I hope you've enjoyed this sort of what I think of the flats and clips, you know, and that video will show if you put your mind to it, you can be faster on a certain type of shoe. So I did not expect to be faster on these flat pedals, especially by 4 seconds on a track that I know like the back of my hand. So yeah, thanks for watching. You know, if you've got any questions, and please comment below what you run and why you run it, because it's good to, you know, hear feedback and, you know, what you do and what you ride. And yeah, I hope you enjoyed that. I'm going to keep on shredding. Remember, give it a thumbs up, subscribe, and keep on enjoying these videos I'm making. So yeah, until next time, guys.